show for tonight's pay-per-view. Again, I'm here with the lovely Clay Monster and the horror Joe Schwarten.
Yep, I
think Clay Monster, thank you for the host.
Yes, sir.
but thanks for coming in, guys. I thought that the main event, crap. I thought the show would be much shorter than it was. I did not know they were going to extend it out that long.
Went the whole 3 hours. I was surprised. That's why I was like, mm-hmm. "Is it just me, or is there more matches?"
Mm-hmm. So let's just get it started. That way, we're not going on for 2 or 3 hours here.
Mm-hmm.
Uh oh, hang on. My dashboard is not letting me mute it, even though I had everything muted, and I have this trouble every single night. But anyway, so yeah, we had the Tozawa and Rich Swann.
So let's just get it started.
There we go. Finally got it. Sorry.
It's okay.
It's so stupid.
Yes, Tozawa, Rich Swann, the Brian Kendrick.
And Noam Dar. So go ahead. What'd you guys think? Well, the result was Tozawa and Rich Swann won.
Called it.
Yep. Still didn't care.
I watched only the ending of it.
The person who cares about 205 Live was
I know. Well, that's because I'm the only one who cares. But I feel bad because I'm like, oh crap, it's already on. Because I do another podcast right before the show starts, so like I was kind of cutting it close.
Yeah.
I thought the match was, it was decent.
I came in to see. I don't remember. It was like right at the end. All I remember is Tozawa kicking a bunch of people, and then like the finish. That was it. And then him and Swann at the end in the ring going ah to each other.
Yep.
But yeah, good for them, I guess. Didn't care. So after that, we got a lovely package with Goldberg, and I just want to hit on this real quick. And for whatever reason, they decided it would be a really cool idea whenever he does his little roar thing, like to make him sound like a lion in the package. And it was so cheesy and so stupid. And it was the beginning of many stupid packages to come for the rest of the night, except for Austin Aries' package, because everybody loves looking at his package. And his package was 4 hours long, but they had to cut it because it was so long. Bravo, sir. Well played.
That is a long package. Yep.
But yeah, so the first match of the night that we actually had of the show was Sami Zayn versus Samoa Joe coming out. And Samoa Joe won clean over Sami Zayn to nobody's surprise.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
So what did you guys think of the match?
It was good.
Yep, agree.
The only thing is I will already start it here that Michael Cole doesn't know what the hell an enziguri is, because he has called multiple different types of kicks enziguris.
Yep.
Well, it's Michael Cole.
Yeah. God damn it, Cole. This is every single time.
I got really excited twice when Sami Zayn was on the top rope. And Joe went over and looked like he was going to go for a muscle buster.
Oh, yeah.
And it didn't happen.
That didn't happen.
But it was all, overall, it was a really good opener.
Yeah, I think so. I just think it really, Joe carried the match, and it showed how much of a varied offense that Joe has in his arsenal anyway, because he was doing a lot of different stuff. And you guys are talking about Michael Cole there. And there was two calls in a row that he screwed up where he meant to say Joe. And I don't remember the first one, but the second one was when Joe, like, just straight jabbed Sammy right in the jaw. And then he fell down. He's like, look at that. Samoa Joe can't take a punch or something like that. and they just rolled with it. And I'm like, Michael Cole. But yeah. Yeah, it was really good offense by Joe, though. So then the next match that we had was the tag match, Gallows and Anderson versus Enzo and Cass. And the outcome of that was Gallows and Anderson's retained by a somewhat dirty outcome. heelish victory. We'll say that.
Yep.
So go ahead, Clayton. What'd you think?
Well, I just want to point out Corey Graves at the beginning of the match called Enzo Super Mario if his mother didn't love him. And I thought the poop emoji on his flat, like his back, like overall flap, was a nice touch. And
I wonder why you thought that.
I know, right? And Anderson's mid-air kick to Enzo's head was excellent.
Yeah, that was. I popped for that. I was like, "Whoa!" Yeah, that was cool.
That was pretty nice. He is really good. I like him a lot. I like Gallows. I'm not such a fan of, but I do like Anderson. He's pretty good.
I would agree.
Mm-hmm. What do you think, Joe? The match. Yes.
I mean, no, the match was it was actually pretty good. It kept it going and everything. Again, that pop with the tag blocking it was a really good spot. That would probably be the most memorable thing from it, just because I almost never see anything quite like that, where you just pop someone right when they go to jump for the tag.
Yes. And
fantastic.
Normally that's when the baby face fire comes in.
Yeah, I mean, he was reeling that whole time, and like it was just like, oh, he's finally going to get it, and nope.
I will say, I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, go ahead. It's fine.
I was going to say, I don't know if I mean, I kind of get it because they're two very different sized people, mm-hmm. not in Enzo and Cass. But I don't know if I like this whole thing that they're doing where they basically make Enzo the punching bag for 95% of the match, and then Cass comes in and here's a boot, look at me, I'm Roman Reigns, clothesline, match is over.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's kind of typically how those bigger matches look, or those, that type of team goes, though, is you'll have a guy that does that.
I know, and that's what I'm saying. Like, I don't know
if
I enjoy that.
Even the New Day does that, because Big E will come into the match, they'll be like, oh, it's Big E, he's going to suplex everything. So. But yeah,
but then I guess I just don't notice it as much with the New Day because you always have Xavier Woods and Kofi.
You mean because they haven't wrestled really in like a month?
They wrestled that ice cream thing tonight.
Yeah.
Tasty. So when Enzo came out, and I know he wears like crazy stupid outfits, but the one he was wearing tonight was really stupid.
Yeah.
Like the velvety, I don't even know what the color that was with the shoes. Just no. But
golden red maroony type looking thing.
Yeah, I don't know what he was trying to do. If he was trying to go for like a Hugh Hefner or what, but
I was thinking like something kind of royal, but it's like it's just not quite there.
Yeah, I wouldn't feeling that too much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But his opening promo was going okay when he was talking like to Milwaukee directly. But then like once they started attacking Gallows and Anderson, like it just started falling so flat with the crowd and just in general.
Yeah. And at first I'm like, oh man, he knows how to pander to a crowd.
Yep. And then he got off the whole city thing and it just started falling flat. And he's been kind of doing that recently with the crowd in general when he's doing all that stuff. Like he's becoming annoying a little bit to people.
Yeah, like, ever since the whole penis thing, pianist, and they tried to make it into the penis joke thing.
Yeah,
it's just kind of
yep. So with the ending of the match, how Enzo actually had his foot up on the rope, but then Gallows came over and like threw his foot off the rope while Anderson had him pinned. That was a finish, but my favorite part of it was as soon as the ref counted 1, 2, 3, Anderson had the best hustle I've ever seen of getting the hell out of that ring because he knew what just happened. That was fantastic. So the next little segment that we got was Samoa Joe and Mick Foley backstage.
I thought it was Steph and
Mick Foley. Well, they were,
Steph and Mick Foley.
Well, they were. That was the subject, though, was Samoa Joe helping KO.
She was talking about, sure. Don't let Samoa Joe, right.
And we really haven't even, like, seen any kind of development with that at all yet.
No, like, not yet.
Like, on Raw or anything, that those two would even, like, any kind of insinuation that they would help each other out, other than we saw, right. Like, one shot with Triple H talking to Kevin Owens. And that
honestly, that whole, like, time, I'm like, why would he?
Yeah. It's like, what?
Why would he go in there? Why would he bring up Samoa Joe for that?
And just to cover it later, again, Mick Foley, like, confronted Joe in person. It was like, if you interfere with that match tonight, you'll have hell to pay or something like that. Mm-hmm. And Joe's face was even like, why would I do this?
Okay,
sure, whatever, Foley.
Have a nice day.
Yeah. So the next match that we had was Nia and Sasha.
Oh, yes.
And that also had the outcome of Sasha beating Nia clean. So, Joe, what's your thoughts?
I called that. Or did I call it? Wait, no.
No, you said...
I actually didn't. I said the opposite.
Yep.
No, I was talking about the other thing. It seems like they are leading to a little bit with Bayley and Nia beforehand is what... But you're right. I don't know. It's a good match, though. I was very surprised. Yeah, I was actually very surprised by that ending.
Well,
anytime there's like a roll-up type pin, though, or like a really quick one like that, I've always sold. You got me.
What do you think, Clayman?
Sasha was dominated the whole match, and I was legitimately surprised by her actually winning because of what happens later. And then I wrote down, what do you get out of this win? Like, Sasha is Sasha.
All right.
Nia Jax was pretty much the women's division Braun. And we just, like, smashed that. So I don't understand.
Well, Nia
It doesn't really build Sasha the way that we were thinking it was going to happen. You know what I mean?
Well, one thing that annoyed me in this match was Nia kept taunting over and over, and stalling.
Yeah, it was.
At first, I was okay, but like the whole last half of the match, I'm like, just stop, just quit. She's like, who's the boss? Who's the boss? And she just kept saying, what now? What now? And I'm like, what now? What to what? What do? Who's saying anything to you right now? Say another line, please. Mm-hmm. And that torture rack that she was doing was torture to watch. It was not very good. I didn't think. Like Sasha just looked like a limp fish up there, just like kind of rolling over. I don't know. It was just weird. It didn't look good. I don't know who's to blame there, but I didn't like it.
I felt with the match though because it did seem like Nia was definitely overpowering her in the beginning, but like Sasha just kept slowly coming back, and I liked, at least in ring wise, like her like just little things here and there, and then like trying to hold on, and then she had like the guillotine hold, and then she almost got out of it, and then they flipped her over into the sleeper, and I liked a lot of that like back and forth between them, like showing, you know, I mean Sasha was definitely struggling through a lot of it, but she kept coming back. You're right, Clayton, though. I will agree with you. Like, I don't know where this can go, though, after this. I thought it was a really good match. Really, you know, the emotion and everything inside the ring was good. But
I just heard the motor revving stuff in the background.
Oh, sorry.
No, it's not. It's no problem.
No, it's Fastlane.
It just reminded me because Fastlane, like, constantly, it's fast like, lane. Every promo.
Yeah.
What you mentioned the guillotine hold that she had. Michael Cole was like, Sasha has her in a... look at Sasha! Like, okay, good job, man. I felt like the match was okay. Like, yeah, Sasha was getting the crap beat out of her the whole time. But, like, with the ending, Raw has been such up in the air with the four for a while now. Like, we were mentioning all the tag teams and all the crazy stuff that's been going on. It's just a hot mess, and this proves it even more. Because they did that little promo with Nia and Bayley earlier in the night, even though they've already done something like this anyway, and it didn't really, they haven't done anything with it yet. And so Nia just lost. So if Nia just lost, why would she be the next to go and face Bayley if she just that lost? Is, and right. if Sasha just wins, you have Sasha winning.
We're the same.
Yeah, like, there's no heel turn from Sasha yet, so what are you going to do there? It's just a mess.
Well, when we get to that part of the night, I have quite a bit to say about the whole, like, it was a perfect opportunity sort of thing, but...
Well, I think one thing that I don't know, but it looked like when Sasha did that roll up the pin at the end when she was trying to do the bridge, I think she was actually trying to grab a hold of the rope for leverage, but she was kept missing because she kept she kept flailing her arm back there.
You think so?
Yeah, I think so, and that would be kind of a.
It makes a little bit more sense.
Mm-hmm. But I don't know.
It's heel. That match was a heel versus a heel, so I don't.
Well, not yet. I'm saying it could be like. Slowly you're seeing a little bit of a move towards that way. That's what I'm trying to say.
Right. I got you.
But, yeah, so the next segment was a nice 20 to 25 minute filler that nobody expected.
Yeah, not at all.
I actually have in caps and underlined and bold and italics and quotation marks, what the fuck is this?
When... Yeah, this is why it went over 3 hours.
Yeah, because they had to have Jinder and Ruru come out for a nice filler moment, and Lana and her sexy space boots.
That's what Rick got out of it.
Yeah, I saw that, and I'm like, I hope she comes out, and I'm like, all right.
I don't know. Rusev is looking pretty good.
I actually have down also in parentheses whatever. That I like long-haired Ruru better.
Yeah.
Yep.
Cesario.
his beard was a little trimmed too.
Yeah.
It's probably.
I don't know. I do like long haired Rusev better, but my point in saying that is it's a big joke because the whole night they're like handsome Rusev.
Yeah.
Look at handsome Rusev. All big show.
I would rather have that than hard body Mahal.
Oh yes. Oh god.
Rub your eyes in pain.
Yeah.
So backstage they had a little promo between Jinder Mahal and Rusev, and essentially they're like, we don't want to be a tag team anymore. They're yelling at each other, and Foley's like, I guess this was earlier in like the pre-show or something, but anyway, he was just like, I'll give you guys singles matches if you want singles matches, and I'll give you somebody that is of equal caliber to you or whatever.
Well, at first they're like, okay, I'll let you guys fight each other. And they're like, no!
Best of seven.
Yeah. Best of
seven.
No.
Well, it's funny that he said that because earlier in the pre-show, they was interviewing Cesaro and Sheamus. And Cesaro and Sheamus, during their little interview, Cesaro says, it's kind of crappy that we're not on the show, right? And I was like, oh, is he really shooting right now? Like, is this legit? And then, well...
Right. Well, and then so they get out, and immediately Jinder and Rusev just start beating the crap out of each other, and somehow
just to see who goes first.
Yeah, just to see who goes first, and Jinder like obliterates Rusev, which was kind of surprising to me, and like knocks him all the way over to the timekeeper's
the bell
square over there, and whatever you want to call that. So then he gets in a ring, and then Cesaro comes out in a fancy new suit. Mm-hmm. And he looked fantastic.
I did, yeah, you look great.
He came out, and I'm like, as soon as I heard his music, I'm like, yes, this makes this part okay now. It has Cesaro in it. And he comes out, and he does his strongman thing of throwing him around. Maybe actually hurt his back. I don't know if he did or not. I feel like he may have, but I don't know. At the same time, even if he did, he was able to muscle him up for a one-arm suplex.
Well, that's the thing, is I thought he hurt his knee last week on Raw.
Yeah, that's true.
And he didn't. So
I just like him so much. Like, he was, before he may have potentially hurt his back, like, it was just showing how strong he was doing some of the stuff, like, literally just catching Jinder in midair.
Oh.
Yeah, that's good.
He's just so cool. But anyway, what'd you guys think? That match there, I was like, I text Clayton during the middle of it. I'm like, if Cesaro loses this, I will riot right now.
Jay, you want to go first, man?
Well, one of the things I thought it was actually kind of good. It was silly, kind of funny. We're not going to add the other match into this, are we?
Not yet. We'll do that next.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So, Cesaro definitely was looking good. I thought it was pretty good, but it's still just, I don't know, it just felt weirdly out of place.
Yep.
And there's more to it that I want to say, but it has to do with the combination of the two matches, so I'll wait.
I thought it was a good match as well. You just got to see Cesaro be Cesaro, and Hardbody Mahal actually showed off like quite a bit of I can't even keep myself from like cracking a grin from saying that, but yeah, he actually showed a little bit of potential there too. But Cesaro, like catching him in midair, doing all that stuff, just
yep.
A+.
Something real quick, you're talking about gender. I've never said it like aloud or anything because I've just been giving him time, but I've always been like, I do not care about this guy. I could care less. I don't want to see him, get him off the screen, because you know how picky I am. But right. I will say, like, the more I've been seeing him, and even like tonight, he's got some really nice old school moves as far as like when he gets him in the corner and stomping them and stuff. Like, he's got some of the older school style, and I like that because you don't see it very much anymore. But yeah, so of course Cesaro wins and he leaves. Jinder's still in the ring like, oh man, I just got the crap beat out of me by a Swiss man. And then Rusev comes in the ring and like obliterates him even more. Just like smash, smash, smash.
Forgot. I still hate the Swiss 1-9. I hate that. God, why? Why?
Oh no, man, I love it. I love it.
Why? What's wrong with the Swiss 1-9?
Everything.
Nothing's wrong with the Swiss 1-9.
Nothing's wrong with the Swiss 1-9.
It's the fact that he calls it the Swiss 1-9. It's just so
I bad. Don't think he does. I think the announcers Michael call Cole. It. Yeah.
I guess it's Michael Cole, I guess, it's technically. Michael but it still Cole. Bugs me. Michael.
So Rusev smashes the crap out of him, rolls him out of the ring, and Rusev's looking all strong and everything, and then we hear, well, it's the Big Show! And then I'm like, hey, this is awesome, the Big Show's coming out.
I was wondering that, too, if, like, the Big Show's gonna come out. I'm like, hey, he's gonna come out, it's probably gonna be this match, and then they did it. I'm like, because he's been trying to, like, come back recently, like, to be more involved. And, yeah. One, he's lost a good bit of weight and everything. He's looking a lot better than he was. So, I was actually pretty happy with it, so.
Well, as excited as I was to see him come out, I remembered why it's not necessarily a good thing that he comes out, because he's so slow. And it's not his fault.
He is the big slow, but, yeah.
But he is so slow. Anyway.
Big slow.
Continue on, sir, either one of you.
Well, I mean, yes, he was moving slow, but at the same time, there was a couple bumps and stuff he was taking. Like, he was actually falling and moving a bit. So, I got a hand to him. And, I mean, he was crap. He was, like, they were throwing each other around and everything. And they were actually, I thought for a big man match, it actually went pretty well.
Mm-hmm.
But the one thing I wanted to add, though, was, in the end, you know, the Big Show ended up winning. I was actually happy with that result. And it kind of, my thought though was because both of them lost, like, that it's going to like kind of like try and keep them together. But my other idea though was it was going to be Cesaro and Sheamus would actually be the two wrestling them. And then they would both lose or something and then they would go at it and be like, well, you want to team back up again? It'd be something stupid like that. But
that's basically what they do anyway.
Yeah. It's probably what's going to happen.
I agree with Joe. Big Show really did put on a good match. I do have written down why. Because anytime Big Show shows up, or anything like this happens, like Big Show comes out, there's no build, it's on a pay-per-view, of all things. Rusev is just too good. And they were like, well, let's get that big shovel out that Big Show carries around, and we'll just have him go down there and dig him a big hole and throw Rusev in it because he basically got buried tonight. If he hasn't been already with all the stupid, like, let's have him and Jinder Mahal team up. Oh, by the way, we have the same four people in the main event week in, week out. Let's throw Rusev in a hole and let's shove Jinder Mahal in that hole too. And that's the end of it.
I agree. I will say something. I don't know if you guys felt this way. I thought the match was going pretty good, like you guys said. And then the end happened to this also, where he picks him up and chokeslams Rusev. He picks him up and chokeslams Rusev. The crowd wants one more. So he picks him up and chokeslams Rusev. And for whatever reason, I thought this spot was really stupid. He picks him up by the beard, throws him over into the corner, and gives him a KO punch. It was so slow.
Yeah, that was
It was so slow. It was stupid. It killed everything that just happened with the three choke slams. And even the crowd was like, bruh.
Yeah, I thought it was dumb, too.
So, yeah.
But otherwise, it was good. Yeah, that ending was dumb.
Yep. So, the next match, I'm going to say probably best match of the night. In my opinion, was Neville.
We got our second Austin Aries promo.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
Yeah, I know. I remember seeing that and being like, "Wait, did I just see this like a half hour ago?"
Mm-hmm.
Because they have packages and we need more. And, and Clayton loves packages.
That's right.
Just ask to show off his package.
But the next match, probably match of the night, was Neville and Jack Gallagher. I think, by far, they probably put on the best match.
Oh, that was fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
I'll let you kids go ahead. Clayton, go ahead.
Okay. I have really good... basically, here's what I have written down. Really good match. That snap suplex into the splash. Dear Lord. I thought Jack Gallagher was dead. We got blood in this match too,
a little bit,
but it was from elbows, so it doesn't really count, I guess.
Yeah,
and those freaking headbutts, man.
That one up on the top rope.
Oh, dude.
Oh, yeah.
That was louder than the Big Show slapping Rusev on the chest.
Well, no, he went shh, and not everybody was quiet.
See? Oh, that's true.
I also like just, you know, the two of them like playing with each other though, like the Gallagher doing the headstand. They'd be like,
yeah.
And then like he finally like got off of him, and then he like threw him and whipped him back in the turnbuckle and just went right back into it. okay, that's fine, because he is like the gentleman, so he's got to play with him a little bit.
Yep.
Yeah.
But no, overall all the spots were great. They were, you know, moving around really good. And in the end, too, as we said, Neville. I think we all said Neville was going to win that one though, because even though it made me realize though, maybe Gallagher is a lot more closer to maybe possibly going. I wouldn't mind seeing these guys go at it again. This is really good.
I think they'll go again at WrestleMania.
Mm-hmm.
I'm really hoping that Neville doesn't drop the belt at WrestleMania, but I could see them doing it just because of the match tonight was very, very, very well done.
Mm-hmm.
And neither one of them, I don't think, excuse me, I don't think either one of them had a botch either. Like everything was, like I was watching, I always watch for that stuff anyway, but I was really watching for it. And those two, for all the crazy stuff that they had going on and all of Neville's flips and everything, like everything was on point. And I would just like to point out the start of my little rant. So I don't know if you guys have noticed this guy, but he was in Los Angeles. He was in Las Vegas. Joe knows already because he has the face. He's been in all the pay-per-views so far that I can remember. But that long-haired dude in the front row of the audience on the left side of the ring,
yeah,
is... At first, I was like, hey, he's in all these shows. That's fine. Tonight, he annoyed me because he held up a sign against Neville where he looked like Gollum. And then he was booing something else. And I'm like, are you... He also wants the Ascension to come back and be a thing. I'm just like, dude, get out of here and shut up. You have no idea what you're talking about. His face now annoys me. Congratulations, sir. Hope you're watching.
Are you talking about the guy who had the
respect shirt?
Okay, well, there was a sign that somebody had that was like the brawny guy and brawn. Is that the same guy?
No, I don't think so. Well,
okay.
I don't remember.
Okay, I don't think it's the same guy. There was also that one guy in the front who was like totally completely like painted in black with just a big
Finn
smile.
Balor?
Yeah, that was Finn Balor, yeah.
It was? Okay.
Well, it wasn't Finn Balor, but we me and Clayton was joking. I said, hey, look, Finn Balor's at ringside.
And then, I said I would have crapped my pants if it was actually...
It actually was?
Yes.
Okay.
Because
it ended up not being him. But
mm-hmm. Well, I thought it was funny, like, he didn't talk or say anything the whole time either. He was just, like, shaking his head and, like, giving thumbs up and stuff.
Yeah, I know. That's what I thought was kind of weird. I'm like, you know, for being all, like, extravagant out and everything, where he's just sitting there watching.
So because that guy was like dissing Neville, I'm just like, see, it's people like these, like this guy here. Everything that Neville was doing in the match, I'm like, how can you not appreciate this? Like, just because he looks retarded. Well, he doesn't look retarded to me because he looks retarded to this guy. He thinks he looks like Gollum, apparently. Like, he's booing him. I'm like, what is wrong with you? Go ahead and
sign. See, the sign wasn't saying that he looked like Gollum. Molly and I have both said this before. Neville legit looks like somebody from Lord of the Rings.
Yeah.
Like, they were not saying... I don't think they were saying that he looks like Gollum. I think they were saying they had the Gollum thing there because if you think Lord of the Rings, that's one of the... Like, the movie universe, anyway. Gollum is still, like, one of the things that you think of. Like, how well he was done.
I don't know, Clayton. I think you're stretching that a little.
I think...
Well, it makes sense to have it there, but it doesn't matter.
Regardless, Neville was...
I think they were trying to say Gollum. I think they were purposely...
Yeah, because he was booing him and stuff, too. So that's why I don't remember what it said. I remember reading it and be like, screw this guy.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't remember what it said now.
I love Neville. He's a fantastic heel.
I'm going to start making lists of all the good signs in the crowd. I actually have two really good ones. During the Sami Zayn and Joe match, there was one that said, I'm only here to see a Samoan Joe or something like that. And it had Roman Reigns on the bottom of it. And then there's another one that said, when it rains, it bores.
Yeah, I did see that.
You forgot about the one that said Braun across like
that
12.
That one was excellent.
Like 12 people. I keep getting off track here. But this match is what 205 Live should be and could be.
Yep.
Like, there's a lot of people that are capable of doing this stuff, but they don't let them showcase and don't let them build enough to do it and let them have a good spotlight. And I think... For Neville saying that he is king of the cruiserweights, or whatever you want to call it, that he really did it justice for the cruiserweight division. Like, so both of them showing, like, this is what we can do, this is what we're capable of.
Mm-hmm.
And, big boner and big pop for the finish. The red arrow came out. That thing is so disgusting. It's so good.
So slick.
Like, just watching it, like, the slow-mo, I'm like, just how? Teach me your ways. So then the next part was the New Day ice cream that we all ask for.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Delicious.
Yep, that's all we gotta say. I think Big E was drunk in all of it.
Yeah. Your voice is in my head. Reference.
Yeah. And then he kept, like, touching and rubbing everybody, and they're like, you sipping something? You sipping something? That's all we really need.
I will say that I did like the the ice cream on the side, like each one of the New Day have a different colored like one's red, one's blue, and one's green, and then when they walked down they each had a different like color pop filter on the top of their mic that was red, blue, and green to match the face. Nice. Which I thought was pretty good, but other than that, it's garbage.
There's something we skipped over. I wanted to say, I think the Paul Heyman thing happened already, right? Where we're at?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I just wanted to say, though, this is the reason why I love Paul Heyman. he came out and did that little promo and pretty much said exactly what we were all thinking with this whole thing with Goldberg. Though it's like, well, if he wins, good. If he loses, okay.
Yeah.
Like, it didn't matter to him. Like, mm-hmm. I think that was probably Paul's idea. Probably everyone else was just like, well, we're going to, you know, build it up so that he comes out. But, and then Paul's probably like, but does it really matter?
I also like when that woman was interviewing him, he was like, I don't think we've met. My name is Paul Heyman. So yeah, the New Day Ice Cream, we're just going to move on from that. So the next match was Good Boy Roman Reigns versus Braun Strowman, and go, whoever wants to go, just go, get it over with.
Joe, go ahead. I got to sit here and shake my head in disappointment for another 5 more minutes.
The ending bugged me, but overall, I actually thought it wasn't that bad of a match. I thought Roman and everything was moving decently well. He had a couple actual moves in there with the Samoan drop and everything looked good, but he's still just... Him and those damn punches just keeps going at it, but he was actually selling everything well, like the monster that Strowman is. I just wish they would have put Strowman over on Reigns. Oh, and Clayton, I just, the whole time, just shaking his head. I mean, I feel for you, bro, but there's some stuff in it. Those two can definitely put on a match at least a little bit together for two big guys.
I agree that it was a good match up until the finish. They just need to stop it with the Roman Reigns stuff. I'm not a Roman Reigns hater. I think he has potential, but his moves are like garbage. Big boot. I got to do a Samoan drop because, haha.
Samoan, yeah.
And then the Superman punch. Get it out of here. I am tired of seeing that every 3 seconds.
Apparently, you're.
I got to go over in the corner. Got to do it again. The drive-by is actually okay.
Yeah, that was all right.
It's not the best move ever, but I mean, it's it doesn't happen every match, and it doesn't happen he doesn't get him outside of the ring and set him up and then do it. And then like 3 minutes later, go over to the other side of the ring and set him up and then do it. Mm-hmm. And then cock his feet each time he does. I will say that Braun got to do stuff yet again that he never does. He looked great when he fell out of the ring and hit his knee. I just had a feeling right then and there that I should just turn it off because the rest of the night was going to be super duper predictable. Mm. When he was running for the spear and Braun stopped it and that running power slam into that table, I was like, this is the reason that everyone should love Braun Strowman.
Mm-hmm.
And then he throws him in the ring and he, like, you know, Braun's knee is still hurting. So he climbs into the ring and an immediate spear out of nowhere. No build, just, oh, I got to do this because it's my fourth move that I do. And as soon as he jumped off the top rope, might as well just counted it out. It's done. GG, no RE, except...
I'm with you. It's just the thing I was liking while watching the match was this whole. It was a good build up, like a Braun Strowman, like just being, you know, Braun Strowman being a monster, and even Roman Reigns, who's this established guy, even though you know a lot of us have a lot of problems with him and everything, but it was this thing like, oh my God, how am I gonna beat this guy? And I just wanted to just be like, you know what? In the end, he just couldn't do it, just to build Strowman up, but.
Here's the thing. Ending. I think that this is going to go to WrestleMania.
Really?
And I think Roman's going to lose at WrestleMania. Okay. Because Braun... if you... If, okay, so the whole feud he had with Sami Zayn.
Mm-hmm.
mm-hmm. in which he got, which he lost that one match. He was so angry the night after on Raw. I think that's the night that he came out and tore up all the Christmas trees and threw all the cruiserweights around all over the place.
Well, he beat somebody with a Christmas tree too.
Right. Yeah, that's true. I mean, I don't see this. I see this going on to Mania just because Braun, being angry. I don't think it's done.
Which brings me to my point of they should have, like I said last night, this should have been a DQ match. And or at least a count out. Like when he put him with the running power slam through the table, count out right there. Should have counted him out then. Or Roman like couldn't beat him, maybe snapped and then, like I said, start beating him with something he shouldn't have, a chair or whatever, and got DQ'd that way and kept this going. Because since I said that now, Roman needs to have a better move set, but I feel like he is underappreciated in how he, in his ability to call a match during the match. Mm-hmm. And because he's been in a few other matches that were pretty decent, but it's just Roman Reigns and everybody craps on him. I want to like Roman Reigns, and I've said that for a long time now. I want to like him, but he has not given me a reason to like him. and I don't mean the backstage, like them forcing him down our throats or creative. He himself and his character has not given me a reason to like him. Right. Because I can look past creative and their stupid crap that they do and how they're burying people like Rusev, and I still like Rusev. But this was definitely a slobber knocker of a match, but the ending was just
right.
It was just dumb.
I see this going. I think that this ends up with him getting a belt at some point. And I feel like Mania is going to be Braun Strowman in the bag.
Of who getting a belt?
Braun getting the belt.
You think it. WrestleMania?
No. He won't get the belt at Mania. He'll have
who he go against.
And by the way, I had Steam Chat up, and I didn't get a message about Taker not showing up.
No, I had it up for you guys to tell me how right I was.
I had it up too for you to tell me how right we were about Taker not showing up because he has a broken hip.
Well, at least I can think creatively. Whatever, man.
I thought me talking about Undertaker dragging Roman Reigns through the match last night with the flappy cookie monster.
I think that was all of us.
I did mention him pulling him down through.
You did.
And that didn't happen.
It didn't happen. So we're both wrong.
That's right.
I guess.
I will not just lay down for this. I knew you guys would come after me about that. I was trying to avoid that.
Whatever. That's okay. I didn't say anything. That is all Clayton.
Joe, this is your time to shine, man. You're leaving me hanging here.
Mm-hmm. Nope.
But.
Oh, I'm leaving you hanging like freaking Boss Man in the Hell in a Cell match.
Oh,
I know. I'm sorry.
So the next match that we had was Bayley and Charlotte for the women's championship. So go ahead, fellas. I think Clayton, go ahead.
Okay. Charlotte dominated this match, carried it.
Yeah. For sure.
I wrote down interference for sure, and this is before anything happened. Bayley was doing okay, and then she botched that hang up, and I was just like, what is even going on right now? She had Charlotte hung up, and then she did that elbow, tried to like do the elbow, but she ended up like high fiving her on the way down.
It did look a little bit weird.
Yeah, real quick, I don't know so much if that was Bayley or if that was Charlotte, because it looked like the way that she had her in there, like, that could have actually been hurting Charlotte, and Charlotte was actually trying to get out of it, but I don't know for sure. Anyway, sorry, go ahead.
Oh, no, it's fine. And we got more of what happens on Raw every week at Fastlane.
Yep.
So...
much.
Bayley did win and broke her, which this is this would have been 17, which, you know, Ric Flair's lucky number is 16 world titles or whatever.
Right.
This was her sixth. This, if she would have won tonight, it would have been 17 pay-per-views in a row, which is some sort of record, I guess they said, men and women's division.
Yep.
And I don't envision that being broken for a long time.
Yeah, well, at least 17 months.
Yeah. I'm unsure. I think I said that I think I said Charlotte was going to win this one, and she didn't.
Nope. And I said Bayley would win.
You did.
I thought they were going to keep her going, and I was definitely right. I mean, I thought it was a pretty good match. I thought Bayley definitely did pretty well. There was a couple little botched things that, even though, I mean, well, like, but you're right. Charlotte is definitely, she's definitely the more pro in there. Like, there was the moonsault where she actually botched the landing a little bit, but then she's like, oh, I'm just going to turn into a, you know, flipping senton or whatever, and they cover that up. And it's just like, what a freaking pro.
Yeah.
You're right. Yeah, Charlotte probably could carry it a little bit, but I thought Bayley definitely held her own. Bayley knows what she's doing in there.
Oh, yeah.
Nope. Why the fuck does she have the belt? She's so like, I do not like her. Like, she looks so weak. She looks so weak in this match. And having Sasha come out and interfere and help her made her look even more weak. I've ranted about her.
You remember we just got done talking about how creative you can look past all that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but she's, yes, but at the same time, but in the ring, she's not doing anything.
You're right, though.
Her offense is so stagnant, like, she doesn't do anything.
I mean, I guess the same can be said about Roman Reigns.
Yeah, I would say
it is, week in, week
Bayley's
out.
Bayley's a lot better than Roman Reigns. So if Bayley was actually doing moves and, like, you know, Bayley suplexes and, you know, crap like that, where she actually did more than five moves, okay?
She does the shoulder charge in the corner, backflip, whatever.
Ooh.
Do another one. Yeah. And Bayley to belly.
Bayley to belly, yeah.
And then the rest of the time is Charlotte flipping her around. She did two.
She did a super belly to back suplex on Charlotte.
That's true, but like Roman Reigns did that. At some point. Sure.
No, but seriously, like, I don't know. I still feel like it's way too... Okay, so she still should not have won the belt as early as she did anyway.
I agree with that.
And that kind of screwed all this stuff up, in my opinion.
Yeah, I kind of agree with you on that. I would say definitely reserved it for, like, a pay-per-view or something. And also, it's not even necessarily that. I still don't like the Sasha interference thing.
Nope.
Like, if they... That is the one thing in this match that bugged me. I thought she would have at least gone over clean on the pay-per-view.
Yep.
But they didn't do that.
That is really the biggest issue with all of this.
Because...
That and the fact that she got the belt so early. They had the perfect amount of time here to build her up and all that. And they could have even had Dana Brooke interfere and then Mick Foley, like one of his like ending things as GM, be like, she gets another match, and if Dana Brooke in a shark cage suspended above the ring, or something stupid, you know, like.
Well, here's the thing, you have a heel in there trying to get the belt, and you have a face coming out and interfering in the match, helping out another face. So you have two faces teaming up on a heel. Why?
Yeah.
Also the heel sending her help back.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, like. I want to say that I like the match, but then like all this other stupid shenanigans they had going on, I'm like, nope, forget it.
Yeah, I get you.
That's two endings in a row that was shit. Speaking of ending the show, the next match we had was the main event of Kevin Owens and Goldberg. So go ahead, fellas.
Joe, I'll let you take this, man, because you were looking forward to this.
I was hoping that there'd be more of a goddamn match to it. Like, because Kevin Owens has been so fantastic, and even if he lost, and I knew he was going to lose, there's no way they were not going to let him lose. But I wanted it to be at least Kevin Owens showing that he can go toe-to-toe with Goldberg. And this was, and the whole stupid thing with Jericho coming out and it just distracting him just long enough for Goldberg just to do it really quick. This really made me sour on the whole Bill Goldberg coming back thing. So far, it's all been just squashes and really quick little things here and there, and there has not been much to Goldberg at all. Even though, like I said, he looks great. He's in fantastic shape for not being wrestling for, what, 10 years. And I was just expecting him to at least try and do more, but nope.
I don't feel like he's... I feel like WrestleMania is going to be a squash match. Lesnar versus Goldberg. I feel like it's going to be a squash match just based on all this because, yeah, Goldberg's in great shape and whatnot, but, like, doing that, as Kevin Owens has pointed out time and time again on Twitter and in ring constantly, I do this every night. I'm Kevin Owens. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, like... like he does that, he is right. Like it is a different, mm-hmm. it's a different situation every night versus once in a blue moon. I kind of assumed that that's what it was going to be. Spear, jackhammer over.
Well, I mean, once I looked at the clock too, and like, there's not that much time left. Oh no.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, Little, how are you doing tonight, man?
Hey, Little.
I'm going to be completely honest. As soon as Jericho came out and I saw the spear, I turned it off. I was done. That was so stupid. I don't even want to say anything about it. It was just dumb. Absolutely ignorant. I knew that somebody was interfering in the match, and yeah. I was okay with the fact Jericho was coming out and interfering with the match.
Yeah, I just expected a little bit more to it than what happened.
They gave us nothing. And
what? I think it was dumb just because they had Kevin Owens doing all that before the bell even rang. So it turned into another minute and 26 second crap.
Right.
I'm doing good. Thanks for the host last night, man. That's no problem. Not a problem, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to be streaming any tonight? But yeah. And, well, the thing, I don't know which one of you guys are saying it about Kevin Owens has been doing so good for so long, but, you know, he's held the belt, that belt now since, what, September? And he's done his due diligence, and this is your reward. Squash by Goldberg. Congratulations.
Mm-hmm. And that's why, again, I think this might have been something I said, that's probably what I wanted, but I'm not going to get it. Because...
mm-hmm.
Exactly, yeah. I mean, Kevin's been fantastic. He's been a fantastic champion. But there's this thing with the WWE right now, and this was a big thing just with the poster at Elimination Chamber. Royal Rumble. Didn't have any of the champions in the front. And they had this thing with, like, the older wrestlers. Like, none of the new guys they have enough faith in. And they just wanted to throw Kevin Owens in there and get him squashed by Bill Goldberg, the established, the guy that everybody knows. Even though he is a monster, and I understand... Bring him in to win, let him get his one more world title thing, do it. I totally get that, but it's just no respect to what Kevin Owens has been doing.
Yep.
Yeah, I agree.
And that's my big problem with it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like, the worst part of it is, well, actually, I would say that with Chris Jericho actually being involved in all this, that he's probably not too happy with the way it's going down either.
No.
Based solely on how everything went down with him and Goldberg like years and years ago, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I say that more than likely is a lot of people backstage that is not happy with how this is going down.
Oh, yeah. Because that's what... who was it that was mouthing off about it? Like... I mean, it's all kind of hard to distinguish now because every week it's like somebody's trashing on Cena because he's part-time now. And he may very well be, but it's kind of hard to distinguish like what was... Oh, wait, it was CM Punk that was trashing on everybody, wasn't it? Because he said that he didn't like how The Rock came back and was getting paid like hundreds of thousands of dollars just to show up at WrestleMania time with Ronda Rousey.
Yeah.
Oh, right, right.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a little while back, but yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Well, he was the first one to actually come out and say it, and then people followed suit, of course.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I mean, that was a show as a whole. That was our send-off pay-per-view into WrestleMania. Yay.
Mm-hmm. I mean, out of the last few pay-per-views we've watched, has there been one where we came out of it and been like, you know what, I like that?
I liked Royal Rumble. The Royal Rumble match.
Yeah.
It kind of fell flat, but I mean, all the matches before that were actually pretty good.
I don't think that I have watched a pay-per-view since Survivor Series where I thought every match was... Not every match, but like Survivor Series, at least with the actual series matches, were actually good.
Right.
But then they reused the ending for Rumble, so...
Didn't CM Punk go to MMA for a time? Yes, he did. Last year sometime. I don't remember when it was, but he lost in, like, no time. Well, I think he went to the second round, maybe, but he lost. And he's trying to be in the MMA scene still, but he's not actually in it. He doesn't have any contractual signings with UFC or anything. Like, they're just kind of in talks, and it's up to Dana White, and Dana White's kind of said... maybe he should look elsewhere, but Punk's still kind of like, but I still want to do this. So,
didn't he get paid like $150,000 for that match, and the other guy got paid like
$15,000? Yeah.
Yeah.
It was very little.
So, we all hope that one day he'll come back to WWE. It'll never.
Yeah. You
know, I don't want to say it'll never happen, but it won't happen anytime soon.
Mm-hmm.
He's probably stomping his foot before he threw punches.
Yep. he forgot what kind of match he's in.
Yeah. Dude, hey, why'd you hit me? You're not supposed to hit me for real.
Yeah, what is this? Whoa, man, whoa. but yeah, so things are more set up now for WrestleMania moving forward, I guess.
That is true.
It honestly doesn't feel like anything changed for the most part, or anything that we didn't expect.
Right. I mean, that's probably kind of the problem with the pay-per-view right before WrestleMania. You know, that the in-between pay-per-views, just because we're just gearing up for WrestleMania. They're not going to shake up things all of a sudden out of nowhere. So.
But they need to. It would make it better, because. I don't know. For me, there's really no hype right now for WrestleMania.
No. I mean, I'm ready for Reigns versus Strowman again.
That's the one match
I'm looking forward to, honestly.
The thing is, are we sure that's going to happen? Like, we technically don't know yet. I mean, you're probably right.
I mean...
I would love to see Neville and Gallagher again, but I don't know if that's going to happen.
Right. I mean, I guess we really don't know for sure what's going to happen as far as...
Well, one point that we didn't mention yet is Kevin Owens lost, therefore he gets a rematch with Bill Goldberg at some point. Because of
maybe.
Well, he does because of the rematch stipulation thing.
Well, that doesn't really mean anything, because AJ got his rematch against Bray with Cena in the same match. So it could be Lesnar, because I, like, based on the raffle stomp that it was tonight, I don't see anything happening with Goldberg after WrestleMania. I feel like it's going to be a big crybaby send-off sort of thing, and then...
Well, I the reason I say that Kevin Owens will face Goldberg at some point on a Raw or something, maybe, is how... Like how Jericho came out and did all that crap. I think Kevin Owens is going to throw a fit and he'll get his rematch. I don't see him not getting that. So, against Goldberg, not against somebody else. But you could be right. But at the same time, though, I think with the AJ thing, that was just some really weird timing, because between the Royal Rumble and Elimination Chamber, it was only 2 weeks.
That's true.
So. I feel the WWE is starting to head downhill, and that kind of upsets me. It's not... honestly...
I feel it's been going downhill for the last 10 years, but whatever.
Honestly, like, right now, they have a lot of good pieces, and they're kind of making they're honestly kind of making strides in the right direction. It's just they still have some of these old bad habits that they have, and right. they'll show up every now and then, like tonight. Because honestly, like, most of the pay-per-views at the end of the year and Survivor Series and even Hell in a Cell, No Mercy, like, all those pay-per-views and everything they had going on at the end of the year last year was actually pretty good. But it just so happens to be at the start of this year, like, the Royal Rumble was okay, kind of fell flat, and everything since then has kind of been lackluster as well. So, you know, it's one of those things, they'll hit a high note and then they go down, so we'll just see what happens.
I think a lot of it right now is they have a lot of great in-ring talent. There's tons of people who are great workers out there. And even some of them who, like Kevin Owens and people who actually are pretty good on the mic and whatnot, but the problem is mostly creative. It kind of goes back to like what you said. They have a lot of these bad habits they keep going back to, and they don't seem to know exactly long-term wise where they're going with anything.
Mm-hmm.
I would disagree. I think that they knew where they were going with Seth Rollins and Triple H, and I feel like that is a very unique, like, asterisk point. Everything else, I would agree with.
Well, the thing with Triple H, though, I feel like the asterisk is the fact that that was probably, since it's Triple H, Triple H had a lot of hand in that as well, though.
Right.
Right.
But also, there's a thing with that, though. It's definitely interesting, but we haven't seen it 100% through yet. So they could still screw it up. But you're right, it definitely has a lot of potential, and it has been a lot more longer term plan. So I'll give you that one.
They were on the right path, and they weren't screwing anything up, because the ending point would have been WrestleMania for
right.
whatever the outcome. And honestly, like, really, the outcome either way would have been fine. Mm-hmm. So I don't really think they could screw that ending up. I felt it going downhill after they made Undertaker lose the streak.
I agree, that was bad.
Mm-hmm.
And but
that made a lot of people upset too with it.
Right. I mean, I think Undertaker should have just stopped wrestling when he was at 20-0. Like, because honestly, I think he's had, what was it, not the, there was one WrestleMania like a year or two ago. Like, he actually wasn't that bad. But he's been, like, hit and miss with a lot of his matches.
So I think that they threw away the opportunity there. Whoever would have beaten The Undertaker at WrestleMania would have really, really benefited from the win.
Yeah.
I mean, the guy who was around 10 years ago, he really needs a freaking push, right?
Right, like, yeah. It'd been great if it was someone, up and coming, but yeah, you're right.
Like, that's the biggest issue I had with it, is if they were going to... I watch a lot, and I know you guys watch a lot of, like, wrestling videos about, like, talking about different wrestlers and how they feel they should go out, like, when they're done. And Undertaker is one of those that believes that you should go out on your back, like, you should lose your last match. I don't think that was the time to end that. Not, like, it might have been the time, but it was the wrong opponent. And, like, I don't even think Cena should have been the one to do it. Like, Cena was the big face that was all over the place, you know? But it could have been somebody like Seth Rollins, not Roman Reigns, not Roman Reigns, not Roman Reigns.
Should have been Roman Reigns. I might have done
that. Honestly, if he was to beat The Undertaker and then turn heel afterwards, I think it would do a lot of good for Roman Reigns.
Actually, I agree. Actually, I think it would have done a lot good for Roman Reigns. Things probably would have went a lot different than the way things have gone for Roman Reigns if he was put in that situation.
Mm.
But
of course, like we said, he still needs to change up his moveset, but for his character, if he turned heel,
right.
I think he would actually make a really good heel anyway, because as a heel, your job is easier in the fact that you can say whatever the hell you want, and you can act however the hell you want, and he kind of
right, his exactly. outfit his outfit actually would make sense if he were a heel.
His great. Outfit, and he just has the look, like when he's given like that serious like scowl, like that's a pretty heelish look, really.
Mm-hmm.
Then he'd have to ditch the Roman Empire thing, though. Oh, no.
Nah, he could totally go full balls to the wall with that.
This is my
Tyson
empire.
Brand?
Mm, yeah, oh, my Brand. Gosh. Make us really hate him.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I'm interested to see what they do tomorrow night on Raw with some of this stuff. Well, mainly... you know Goldberg's going to be the opening promo.
Oh, yeah.
And that's going to take up a nice 30 minutes of the show, probably. And he's going to sit there and yell at his kid, "How about that, boy?"
Yeah.
And then spit.
Why?
Bah, 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 bah. Did you see him keep doing that? He's like, "Ah, bah, 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 bah." Okay. Crazy old man. Anyway. Anything else you folks would like to add?
There's one thing that we skipped over that was very important, and I don't know why we skipped over it. What the hell was up with that Jetsons movie?
Oh, they had that the other day, too. I don't
really? I haven't seen it yet. But, yeah, I kind of wondered the same thing, because the Scooby-Doo one at least had John Cena and The Undertaker and, like, actual big names. And then this one had, like...
The Big Show is taking over the world.
Yeah. Did they even have them doing their actual voices?
Maybe. I don't know. I couldn't tell.
It didn't sound like The Big Show, but it did sound like Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins. Yeah. And I feel like they had some other... They had Vince McMahon in there, too.
They did.
Mm-hmm, but that one didn't sound like Vince. No, so that's why I was kind of confused, but... Oh, well.
But no, they've been advertising that on Raw for a few weeks now. It's a commercial.
Yeah, I always watch the later shows where they don't have the commercials for that stuff, so...
Yeah. But yeah, that's... Yeah, that was really important, Joe.
Yeah, I mean, what the hell? So, I mean, that's a normal thing that they've been doing, is just mixing up with these old Hanna-Barbera things?
Yeah, apparently.
They did the Scooby-Doo one. I think it was Scooby-Doo, and it was something to do with WrestleMania, I think.
I think this one does, too, a little bit.
Because you need to sell more merch.
Yeah, apparently.
Yeah.
And you need to sell more ice cream, apparently, too.
Yeah. Well, that's different. Okay, the New Day is selling that.
And the New Day can sell.
And Dean Ambrose can't.
And Dean Ambrose can't sell a damn thing.
Oh, I forgot to mention during the Roman Reigns match when they were saying, when the crowd was chanting, "Let's go, Roman. Roman sucks."
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to sound sexist here, but it sounded like whenever they were chanting "Let's go Roman," it sounded like women. Like it sounded like most of the women in the arena was saying that, and then and then it was followed up with all the guys going "Roman sucks."
And it was funny because it was like, go ahead, Joe.
I was going to say, I think it was like Cole or something. Like, it was like, "Yeah, we got to rambux this crowd here in Milwaukee." I'm like, "No, they just don't like Roman Reigns."
And then they're not going to like the outcome of the match. So,
yeah, right. We haven't liked the outcome of anything involving Roman Reigns in a while now. So stop. But I liked how, the crowd, when he was close by, would be like, "You suck. We don't like you." And then the one guy in the boss's Red Sox outfit, like, actually got up and flipped him off right in his face and everything else. I'm like, yep, that's a Red Sox fan.
Yeah. I'm wondering who he is best buds with in the back. He just let him go heel or something.
Vince?
Yeah, Vince just loves him.
I don't know if you know this or not, but Vince McMahon likes big sweaty men.
Big sweaty men? Yeah.
You know, tomorrow's episode of that is going to
be
like an hour of that.
Yep. What was I going to say? I don't remember now. Had something to do with Roman. Well, yeah, I mean, they had... So the Survivor Series thing was okay because he actually lost. Mm-hmm. But then we had the Royal Rumble. He came in for whatever reason.
He ruined
the Royal Rumble.
He ruined the Royal Rumble.
I don't know. I don't understand how they don't see this as a problem. I don't get it. Why do they keep doing it? Well, we done invested all this into him. Okay. Just stop, because you do a lot of other things anyway.
It's fucked up so much.
And, I mean, from somebody who's, like, would just be coming in, if you just gave them, like, an outline of everything that's happened in the past 6 months and you said you gave them the description of what a heel was and what a baby face was, they would go, he's a heel.
Mm-hmm.
He has to be.
Well, here's the thing. If you look, hang on. If you look back 3 weeks ago, Samoa Joe beat Roman Reigns clean in his first match on Raw. Now fast forward 3 weeks and Roman Reigns beats Braun Strowman clean, who nobody has beat yet. So, mm-hmm. like, what the fuck is this momentum shift for him? Like, it's all over the damn place. They'll feed him to whoever, but yet he's the one to take down Strowman. Why?
Well, 2 weeks before... Okay, so 2 weeks ago, he got beat by Gallows and Anderson.
Yeah.
And they made him have that, like, little moment of, like, oh, God, how can I do this? There are two people in the ring. I can't Superman punch two people at once. And then all of a sudden, he's like... goes from that to the next week just burying Anderson and Gallows, and then getting power slammed to hell by, and that was a power slam to hell, by the way, like through that table. And then I have no idea. I'm going to be mad about that, and I'm probably going to be mad at WrestleMania because, Joe, you don't like Randy Orton. Roman Reigns is my Randy Orton.
Oh, okay. I mean, I don't blame you for that either. He doesn't rank much higher than Randy Orton for me either.
He's Ruin Reigns is what his name is now, so.
Ouch.
It's just, yeah. I mean, yeah, Randy with me is just, he's just, like, he's almost in a way like Roman to me, like where they just keep giving him things. And he's not bad or anything in the ring or whatnot, but it's just, he's just that guy they always go back to just to throw stuff to. And I'm like, he's just not deserving of it at the time.
See, Randy's been with the company for a long time.
Oh, yeah, he has.
And so I kind of get that, but Roman hasn't really done anything other than I'm a generational wrestler.
Mm-hmm.
And Randy. I should be in this.
With Randy,
Randy's not a generation wrestler.
No, that's not what I'm saying. He was, but yeah.
But with Randy, like, he really hasn't done anything like big picture in a long time, though. Like, the biggest thing he's done in the past year or more was him and Bray had the tag belts for what, a month, and lost to American Alpha.
Oh, yeah,
that's
right.
The two Kurt Angles.
Yeah. But yeah. So anyway, that's enough rambling. We'll cut it off here.
Okay.
All right. So, Clay Monster and I will be back Wednesday to do our Raw and SmackDown review for the week. I'm sure we'll have more of this ranting to say about what just happened here. So, yeah, thanks everybody for coming in. Thanks, guys, for joining me and having this wonderful discussion.
Of course.
And we'll see you guys next time.
Later.
Yep, see ya. Mm-hmm.